We are going to turn our attention to two different characteristics of the troposphere. The first is the troposphere under normal conditions, which means increasing altitude results in decreasing temperature, or decreasing altitude results in increasing temperature. The second would be anomalous conditions. So that would mean the opposite of this. In other words, increasing altitude results in increasing air temperature. First is going to be the normal conditions. Then we'll come back in separate videos and pick up the anomalies. Under normal conditions in the troposphere, increasing altitude results in decreasing temperature and vice versa. So in other words, decreasing altitude results in increasing air temperature. This happens at what's known as the normal lapse rate, or the NLR. The NLR, or normal lapse rate, describes average temperature change with increasing or decreasing altitude in the troposphere. That average change is 3.5 degrees Fahrenheit per 1,000 feet. Let's try it with some math. This is a diagram of a mountain. I just put some elevations on the mountain. You can see 0, which is sea level, 2,000 feet, 5,000 feet, 8,000 feet, and 10,000 feet along the slopes of this particular mountain. Let's also assume this, that the given is 65 degrees, meaning at 2,000 feet, the air temperature is 65 degrees. What we're going to do now is this. We're going to figure out what the temperature is at 5,000 feet, 8,000 feet, 10,000 feet, and sea level using the normal lapse rate to calculate these temperature changes. Obviously, without a given, you cannot do that. But we have a given. At 2,000 feet, we know it's 65 degrees. So let's use the normal lapse rate to calculate what the temperature is at 5,000 feet. First thing we do is look at this. How many thousands of feet difference is there between 2,000 feet and 5,000 feet? Of course, you just take 5,000 minus 2,000, you get 3,000. What we're going to do is we're going to multiply that by the normal lapse rate. When using the normal lapse rate is already in thousands. It's 3.5 degrees Fahrenheit per 1,000 feet. Because of that, what we do is this. We take 3.5, which is the normal lapse rate, times 3, which is representing the 3,000 feet difference between 2,000 and 5,000 feet. 3.5 times 3 is 10.5 degrees. Now, is it 10.5 degrees hotter or colder under normal circumstances at 5,000 feet than it is at 2,000 feet? Of course, the answer is it's colder. So we take the given, which is 65 degrees, subtract the 10.5 degrees, and what we end up with is 54.5 degrees. That means that at 5,000 feet, the air temperature would be 54.5 degrees. Let's try another one. If we're going up to 8,000 feet, and we were starting at 5,000 feet, from 5,000 up to 8,000 is another 3,000 feet. I'm going to tell you why I personally don't like to do it that way. If you're doing this kind of math on an exam, and you get the first answer, and you incorrectly do the math, even though the math is not exceptionally difficult, if you have the incorrect answer at 5,000 feet, and then you use that incorrect answer as your base to get up to 8,000 feet, what are the chances you're going to get an incorrect answer at 8,000 feet? Like 100%? That's right. So when I do this, I always start from the given because I know the given is correct. Therefore, I would go from 2,000 up to 8,000 feet. That would be a 6,000 feet difference in elevation. What do? We take the normal lapse rate, which is 3.5. We multiply that by 6 for the 6,000. 3.5 times 6 is 21 degrees. It's going to be 21 degrees cooler up there at 8,000 feet than it was at 2,000 feet. What we do is we take 65, which represents the given at 2,000 feet, minus 21 degrees. 65 minus 21 is 44. That means that the air temperature at 8,000 feet is 44 degrees. Let's do another one. You're probably getting the rhythm of this now. If we're going from 2,000 feet up to 10,000 feet, how many thousands of feet are we going up? 8, right? So what do? We multiply the normal lapse rate, which is 3.5, times 8, which is representing the 8,000 foot of difference between 2,000 and 10,000 feet. 3.5 times 8 is 28 degrees. Is it going to be 28 degrees hotter or colder up there at 10,000 feet? The answer, of course, is colder. So we take 65, which is a given, minus 28. That leaves us with 37 degrees. That means at 10,000 feet at the top of this particular mountain, the temperature is 37 degrees. Now we need to find out what the temperature is down at sea level. If we're at 2,000 feet and we know the air temperature is 65 degrees, and we're going down to sea level, how many thousands of feet are we going down from 2,000 down to zero? 2, right? 2,000 feet. So we're going to take 3.5, which is the normal lapse rate, times 2. 3.5 times 2 is 7. But remember, we're going down, which means air temperature will be going up. Because of that, it's 65 plus 7, which equals 72. That means that at sea level, the air temperature is going to be 72 degrees. Just remember that as you go up, on average, air temperature is dropping by 3.5 degrees. If you're at sea level and you go up 1,000 feet, on average, air temperature is 3.5 degrees colder. If you go up 2,000 feet, on average, it will be 7 degrees colder. 3,000 feet, 10.5 degrees colder, and so on.